our last board meeting to kind of talk about this idea, and he asked for us to put it on the agenda. So as part of his senior project, he will be presenting to you reasoning for bringing varsity letters to the high school band.
And then what I'm passing out is the presentation I have, and then behind that is a, what is drafted. For the most part, it's pretty final, rubric that will be used in assessing, qualification for lettering in band or choir.
That's it, you don't have any of those.
No. Hello, my name is Spencer Byrne, and I'm a senior here at Gibraltar High School. Early in my band career, I noticed there weren't any letters in band or choir, and I didn't think much of it. However, as my years in band progressed, I started to see and hear people from other schools with letters for music, and I wanted to know why we didn't have them. Then in my junior year, I saw the senior projects that Mrs. Bremer had assigned, and I knew right away that what I wanted to do was do Mr. Eckhart justice and make it my goal to reinstate varsity letters into our music program. And that is what I'll be proposing to you tonight. Because a student taking band or choir isn't doing it just because it's an easy A. Instead, they're doing it to make music, to move their audience with unspoken meaning and emotion. While our school has made an effort to give appreciation to our music department, we are still lacking the recognition that is fully required to give support to our wonderful student musicians. I know I'm speaking for a lot of Gibraltar's musicians when I say that music is our sport. Even though our sport doesn't involve a ball or athletic ability, it still requires as much, if not more, time, dedication, and practice as any other sport offered at Gibraltar. There are a countless number of students that practice their instruments after school or at home, trying to perfect their scale patterns and pass the person that's ahead of them in their method books, or even practicing just for the sake of practicing. Mr. Eckhart and Ms. Bondison both provide lessons to over 80 students in the school. That's double the amount that most high school band directors, band and choir directors give lessons to. And they should be able to award their musicians excellence through a means other than giving them good grades and verbal praise. The Gibraltar Pep Band also supports our school's sports teams' games at least once per sport in the fall, and all but the home conference games during finals week in the basketball season. Some athletes are even playing in the band supporting the other team. A few months ago, I had contacted the band directors at Denmark, Kewanee, Algoma, Luxembourg, Casco, Southern Door, Sturgeon Bay, and Sebastopol High Schools to see if they offered letters in band and or choir. As it turns out, they've been offering varsity letters for their music programs long before they started teaching at their school. When I asked why they thought lettering in music was important, Naomi Files of Southern Door High School said, "It validates all the effort my students put into our school. I'm not good at sports, and a number of my students aren't either, and that's okay because we have other talents which can service our school and our community. Often band students are putting in more extracurricular time on their instruments and various activities than some athletes, and the letter system is one way of honoring the work they are putting in." She also adds that schools are so much more than sports now, and we should be honoring all activities equally. I felt that way when I was in high school, where I lettered in music 8 times, and I still feel that way today. Heidi Hintz then said, of Sturgeon Bay High School, said, It is important to the students and their families who have invested a lot of time and money into being in the music program. For many of our students, band is their sport, and this letter award is their badge of honor, similar to that letter awards athletes get. And then Tanya Hassenjager at Sebastopol High School said, "Having a letter system in music recognizes exemplary leadership and activities of individuals, much like sports and academics, some in which may only thrive in the music world. All of these band directors have one very prominent message. It gives recognition to the students who put in as much, if not more, time and effort into practicing their instrument and musicianship as athletes do in practicing their sport and sportsmanship. Not only does it recognize a student's hard work and dedication, it also gives them something to look forward to achieving. back when I was in middle school, I never really practiced in my method books. Don't get me wrong, I love playing tuba, but for me it was a little boring. That behavior and mindset continued in my freshman year of high school, until I encountered more challenging pieces of music. Rather than working on my method books, I practiced my music. However, I lacked some of the skills that I needed to play my part right, and I still struggle with that issue today. I regret not being proactive in my playing, because I was never motivated to practicing. Having a music letter would give students the motivation to practice, because it would reward and recognize the hard work that students put into being a musician. A letter would also allow students to display the various medals that they can earn for earning a third, second, or first on their solo and or ensemble performances at District State Solo and Ensemble. Had I known earlier that you can get medals at solo and ensemble, I would have asked for one every year that I went. However, because I had nothing to put them on, there was no real point in asking. I think that it would have been cool to be able to show and have something to remember that I've earned first at state, the highest score possible, 2 years in a row for my tuba solo. Even going to state is an honor in and of itself, so being able to remember that honoring experience would be something that is truly special, just like how athletes can put their medals on the varsity letters that they earn. My goal tonight is to convince you, the Gibraltar Board of Education, to allow the reinstatement of the varsity music lettering system at Gibraltar High School. With the help of Mr. Eckert and the other band directors in the conference, I have created a fair and well thought out rubric that will set the standard for lettering in both band and choir. To earn a letter in band, students must accumulate at least 200 points throughout their high school career. Students will earn points from attending performances, playing at pep band, participating in solo and ensemble, playing in honors bands, playing in jazz band, giving lessons to middle schoolers, and attending camps. Additionally, Mr. Eckert or his successor may award any additional points that they see fit. Each student will earn a minimum of 50 points a year, considering they march in the Fall Fest parade and perform in the winter, spring, and Memorial Day concerts, each worth 10 points, and if they attend the required amount of pep bands for both semesters, 5 points each semester. Additionally, points will accumulate year to year. This means that by the end of a student's senior year, they will have accumulated the minimum number of required points to earn a letter. However, if a student earns 200 points before their senior year, they will earn that letter that same year. If they earn more than 200 points, then the excess will count towards next year's total. Earning a letter in choir is relatively similar to earning one in band, but with a few exceptions. Students will have to earn a minimum of 120 points throughout their high school career instead of the 200 in band. Students will earn points by attending the fall, winter, and spring concerts and performing at solo and ensemble, performing in honors choirs, and by attending camps. Additionally, Mrs. Bondison or her successor may award any additional points that they see fit. Each student will earn a minimum of 30 points, considering they perform at the fall, winter, and spring concerts, each worth 10 points, totaling to 120 points for over 4 years. This means that students will have earned the minimum number of points required to earn a letter by their senior year. The whole process previously explained for band applies for choir students, with the exception that for choir it's 120 points, not 20, or 200. Students will be awarded their letters with all other awards presented at the end of the spring concert. When students receive their first letter, they will not only receive the physical letter, but they will receive a lighter pin that says either band or choir, according to which one they're in, so that you can differentiate between the two. If a student has earned another 200 or 120 points respectively after they earn their first letter, they will receive a service bar instead of another letter and pin. If a student is in both band and choir, the student will receive a lighter pin for whichever class they letter in first. If they letter in the other class the year or years after that, they will receive the pin just for that class and not another physical letter. If a student earns both of their letters in the same year, then they will earn the letter in the first pin at whichever concert they have first, and at the second concert, they will receive the pin for that concert. In addition, Mrs. Bremer, the head of the Varsity Letter Club, has agreed to absorb some of the costs for letters and pins into her activities budget. If all other schools in the conference offer varsity music letters to their students, why shouldn't we? Because Gibraltar is a school that has so much pride and support for their music program, it only makes sense that varsity letters are offered to its band and choir students. More so now because Gibraltar used to offer it, and we are now the only school in the conference that doesn't. Gibraltar should not be a school that just awards its athletes, especially since the music department sends more students to state competitions each year than all the athletic teams combined. Just this year alone, we are sending over 20 musicians to the state solo ensemble competition at the University of Wisconsin, Green Bay, in May. If athletes can display their medals on varsity letters, then so should we. Thank you for listening.
I just want to thank Spencer for coming forward. I'm really proud of him. You know, a lot of people can just sit back and complain about how something's not right or something's not fair or there's a problem, and yet they don't have the courage to step forward and know that they can make a compelling argument and make a difference and change something. And so if nothing else happens, I'm very proud of you for coming forward and doing that and showing our students that when you can do something like this and you believe in something and you come forward in a positive way with a compelling argument, you really can make good changes. So thank you, Spencer, for coming forward.
Very questions. Well written and a lot of research. You, in your research, when was the letter, varsity letter for band and choir drop? Do you have any idea?
No.
Linnea, was it in there when you were there?
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Mark, did you play in this band?
I believe we had it.
Yeah, I thought we had it too. So.
Any idea why it was dropped?
No.
I think maybe change of director, perhaps. You know,
possible.
Somebody dropped the ball.
Know.
It precedes Mr. Eckhart.
I think it precedes Mr. Blonick also. It might have ended with Summer Felt. Did you? I do not believe. Okay. So I think it would come and go, perhaps, depending upon the previous director. Sort of pass the baton to the next.
Yeah.
Would be the hope. And the hope would also be, because I've been getting questions for, would this include other activities, mm-hmm. or whatever. It wouldn't, because this is just what my main focus is, but I do have the hopes that it would set the precedent, it would be a precursor to other letters being offered in other activities.
Mm-hmm. In your research with and getting the point system, is this coming from the other schools?
Yes.
Okay.
It is well based off of.
Mr. Eckhart as well, right?
Yes, it is well based off of what they have had set in place before.
And Mr. Eckhart and Mrs. Bonison are
mm-hmm.
on board. And
yes.
Okay.
I think this rubric would do a nice job of setting up if there were other groups that wanted to present to the board,
yeah.
That they could use this as a model moving forward and very easy to work with.
Another point that's really nice about it is that it is two pages. So it did print two-sided, but it would be printed one-sided with one on each page. So there would be a student copy, which is that first one, and then there would be the teacher copy, which is the second one, so that the student marks down what they did. So it's not left to Mr. Eckhart and Mrs. Bondison to remember all the things that all their students did. Instead, at the end of the year, they would have their students fill out that form, and then they would have it, and they would make sure that it's all correct, and that they would think, calculate the points that the student earned.
There's so many layers of good in this. I just love it. I mean, stronger participation, honing the skills of whatever piece you're playing. I know there's been times when Charlie's tried to get a band for a parade mm-hmm. and the bus shows up fairly full and he has to cancel. So getting our band out there for parades, et cetera, would be great. So I love all of this. Thank you.
Rick?
A couple questions that came to my mind is the rubric for the letters. How close is that to the grading rubric?
For the most part, it's unrelated to it. The only part that it matches with the grading rubric is that performances, because you are graded if you attend the performances, but it is mostly based on outside work. If you do just do the performances, you will earn a letter, but only by your senior year. The only way to earn a letter before that is if you go to solo ensemble, if you go to band camp, if you go to all these different opportunities that you have. If a student were to pursue that, then they would be able to letter well before their senior year.
But some of those, like some of the honor groups, have to be based on the director's
discretion.
So that will
just like coaches do.
That would eliminate some from having the ability to go.
No, from my understanding, how they do it is the student in question. They fill out an application. They give it to their director. And for Bama Honors Band, all the directors in the original conference that they have Bama in, they all come together and then they all discuss what students they want to have. Because a lot of the students that go are usually the best of the best. They usually have already performed at solo ensemble. They have multiple firsts on events that they've performed in. So it's a lot of that as well. It's usually all of the directors coming together and basing it off of what's listed on that application, not necessarily from the letter.
Any other questions?
Yeah, I think it's a great idea, okay? I've three kids that play band, they all won at state. The time they put into this, a kid that really cares about music should be rewarded. Just like the kid that's gonna excel in you know, to go the extra step and take the hard course in physics rather than the easy course in physics, because you can ace that, the one that wants to get challenged. The time that's involved just going to all these pep bands, you know, you know, somebody when they're young, somebody's gotta drive them here. You know, there's pep band this night, that night, and you're there, you know, to fire up the crowd and your players and everything else. And then practicing for state, just to go to solo ensemble, if you care about it, let's put it that way, that time takes lots of time, you know? Then you're sitting there practicing. My kids are, I've got a couple kids here. This one's going for three different pieces at state. This one's going for two. This is all time that they're doing besides all this homework they're doing. You know, granted they're not staying after for basketball for an hour and a half or whatever, but they're doing this on their time besides taking the class. So they should be rewarded. And this, it's about time. I didn't even know they ever had it. I can't hardly believe that somebody didn't bring it up earlier. I didn't know the other schools had it, you know? I was in school, 50 years ago,
you know? I want to say I support your idea. I think it's great too. As a coach, just one thing that you may not have thought about that maybe should be written in there somewhere is about code violations. I know I bring that up because I learned about them a lot this year. Right now, if you are as an athlete, you lose your letter. There are a number of athletes where I couldn't give them letters based off of one-time, you know, mistakes. And I know that that's your. If you lost that, that would be devastating because that's an entire year. Mm-hmm. So just something to think about on how the wording is for that and how you work with the administration on trying to get that covered.
Definitely. One of the things was, because there is no specific handbook for band necessarily that states those code violations. For sure, the band or choir directors would have the ability to revoke points if the situation set the precedent for that action.
It would fall under the activities code, is what I'm saying.
As we looked into the summer for our updating, when I bring the co-curricular code to the school board at that time, if you approve tonight, we'll certainly have plenty of time before Spencer graduates and to sit down with Mr. Eckhart and Mrs. Bunsen to address that and figure out how that fits and accumulates over time regarding the co-curricular code. I'm glad you brought that up.
Another point I didn't make was that the idea was also to have it effective, to desirably have it effective immediately, so that, because there are still a lot of students here that we aren't putting in a lot of work, and so it would be nice to have it set action as soon as possible so that students can get that recognition at that last concert.
Another thing is this year we go to Disney every 4 years, okay? This year, it was such a disappointment, the number of kids that didn't go to Disney, you know? I mean, this is an opportunity of, you know, to have a lifetime in high school to be able to do this. You know, some people didn't have money. Well, then we need to figure out how they, if they spent their money doing something else, we need to figure out how they can go as a band. We wouldn't take half of a basketball team to a tournament. It's like, it should have been a no-brainer, but some of these, I mean, like, just in our senior class, after being all 4 years, and then you don't go to this, it's like, wow, you know? You should have the drive to want to go to it, especially when you're probably good by your fourth year, and you're part of the band.
I am looking for board action on this tonight so we can move forward with the plan.
I'd like to move to approve varsity letters for high school band employer beginning.
I'll second.
Motion by Britt, second by Linnea to approve varsity letters as of tonight. And that will include further study and code of conduct. Yeah. And so we have it in our policy. One or the other, yeah. Any other discussion? All those in favor of that motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Thank you very much.